Well, hi there. I'm here today with one of the greatest snakes in the world. One of them we've already covered in our video, five of the best pet snakes, and that is the Western Hognose Snake. And we give the Western Hognose Snake an overall score of 4.2 out of 5, and that's going to come down to our five categories: handleability, care, hardiness, availability, and upfront costs. If you've seen our other videos, 4.2 is a very high score, and they deserve it. And we also want to talk to you about why they didn't get a 5 out of 5. So let's start with handleability. For handleability, we give the Western Hognose Snake a score of 5 out of 5. Honestly, it doesn't get any better than this. They are just amazing snakes to handle. For starters, they're very unlikely to bite. They're a venomous snake, so you wouldn't want to get bit by one. But if you got bitten by one, it could get a little bit of venom in there, and your finger would swell up like a banana, and have a little banana finger for a while. Wouldn't be a big deal. But that is not what they do when they get scared, at least not very often. First thing, it's gonna puff up, and it's gonna try to look big, and it's gonna hiss and make a scene. If that doesn't work, it's got a phenomenal plan B, which is strike at you with its goofy nose, because the Hognose Snake is named the Hognose Snake because it's got a face like a shovel. And I love that goofball face of the Hognose Snake, and they will start striking at you with their mouth closed and just poke you with that nose. And if that doesn't work, there's a plan C, which is to roll over onto your back, show off your belly, which is in some Hognose Snakes, not so much in her, but in a lot of Hognose Snakes has a little bit of bright coloration like orange and black bands. They'll roll over, they'll open their mouth, they'll stick their tongue out and let out a nasty smell. What is probably going on with them though when they roll over and play dead is that they are probably advertising the fact that they are full of toad toxins. So in the wild, and we'll talk about this a little bit more later on, Hognose Snakes eat a lot of poisonous amphibians. A lot of people don't know the difference between being poisonous and venomous, so I wanted to make sure you knew that if it bites you and you die, it was venomous. And if you bite it and then you die, it was poisonous. So if you eat a toad, you might die. So don't eat a toad. Toads are poisonous. Hognose Snakes are venomous, but the thing is they eat toads. But as is the case with every known poisonous snake, there is the possibility that the Hognose Snake keeps some of that toxin. It's called sequestering. It sequesters that toxin in its own body. And what it's doing when it rolls onto its back and letting off that smell is it's letting things like crows and dogs and possums and raccoons, things that smell really well, it's letting them know, hey, I'm full of toad poison and you probably shouldn't eat me. And that's something actually that we still need to test in the scientific community to know one way or another. But there's a very good chance that Hognose Snakes are venomous and poisonous. And for that reason, they don't tend to bite, which makes them wonderful, wonderful, wonderful captives. Beyond that, their behavior, and you can probably see that with this girl here, is that they behave a lot like a very big snake. They just sort of plod about. They're not quick and darty. They just are wonderful. And they just sort of hang out with you and explore. Honestly, the freakiest thing they do when you're handling them is every now and then they'll sort of nuzzle into you with that nose because they're trying to dig. That's what they do with their shovel faces. And that can sometimes feel like, is it starting to chew on me? Because a Hognose Snake doesn't tend to strike at you, but they do love food. And so if you ever get bit by a Hognose Snake, it's probably because you smell like a mouse or something, and it's come up and gone nom 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 onto you. This Hognose Snake actually is a fairly good size one. This is a female. Males will never even get this big. Females will get a little bit bigger than that, but that is a very manageable size to handle. They pose absolutely no danger to you at all. The only negative, really, as far as their handleability, well, I guess there are a couple. One of them is that they're small, and so, you know, a child or something could squeeze them and hurt them very badly. So, as with anything small, you gotta be careful that you don't crush it. But the only other negative I know about Hognose Snakes is they all seem to go through this like adolescent grumpy phase. And during that phase, they tend to hiss a lot and do those little mock strikes, and then all of a sudden they grow out of it and they become the perfect snake. So we're still giving them a score of 5 out of 5, though during that adolescent phase it drops down to a 3 out of 5 for like 10 minutes. When it comes to care, We give the Western Hognose Snake, again, a score of 5 out of 5. Assuming that you get a captive-bred individual and not a wild-caught individual, they're going to be very easy to feed. And the reason I make that distinction is because in the wild, they're going to be feeding on things like amphibians, toads, and things like that. And as is the case with a lot of species of Hognose Snakes, you're going to need to have a supply of toads to feed them, and that is not an easy thing to do. But if you get a captive-bred individual, they eat stuff. You should be feeding them primarily a diet of rodents. They do very well on a rodent diet. You don't need to scent them with toads or anything like that to transition them onto rodents. They usually start off just great. They're also going to need a very reasonably sized enclosure because they're not big snakes and they're not super active snakes. Now, a larger enclosure is still going to be better for them, but you're not going to need an enclosure like you would need for a boa or even a corn snake. And that is fantastic. And that enclosure can be relatively simple. It's going to need a good basking spot, which can be provided by something like an undertank heater. They're going to need good substrate, a locking lid, water bowl, hide, and that's about it. As always, we've got those kinds of things down in the description. If you want to check them out, those are some that we recommend. When it comes to hardiness, again, the Hognose Snake gets a score of 5 out of 5. This is as good as a reptile is going to get. They are solid, solid little captives. Really, they should do phenomenally well for you, especially assuming that you have a captive-bred individual, which we always recommend, and you've got it from a reputable breeder in good health. That snake is going to do well for you. The only reason it wouldn't would be if you're just not giving it the things that it needs to live. If you're not giving it food, if you're not giving it water, if you're not giving it an acceptable basking spot, you could lose your Hognose Snake. Short of that, they're probably going to thrive for you. They're just phenomenal. It's going to be really easy to maintain proper humidity for these guys because they come from parts of the United States where the humidity is low but manageable. Basically, all you're going to need is a water bowl in order to maintain proper humidity in the enclosure. You definitely don't want it wet, but that's the case for almost everything. When it comes to availability, this is where the Hognose Snake lost a few points. We give the Hognose Snake a score of 2 out of 5. And some of you might be thinking, what in the world? I have seen Hognose Snakes all over the place. That is true. In some places, Hognose Snakes can be relatively common. At the same time, in other places, Hognose Snakes can be completely impossible to find. Some of this comes down to the fact that they are a venomous snake, and so some areas have laws that prohibit them from being sold or owned or even transported through those areas. And so if you live in one of those places, you need to be aware of your laws, and you might be aware of the fact that you can't get one even if you're looking for one. In other areas, they're relatively common, but not everywhere. You know, that these snakes are fantastic. People are having a great deal of success with captive breeding. There are also a lot of morphs available for Hognose Snakes. Those morphs are going to be harder to find than, say, ball python morphs or corn snake morphs or leopard geckos, those sorts of things that have lots and lots of morphs on the market. There are a lot of morphs. You'll probably need to go directly through a breeder to get most of them. When it comes to upfront costs, we give the Hognose Snake a score of 4 out of 5. We honestly almost gave it a score of 5 out of 5 because their enclosure, that is going to be one of the least expensive setups that you can have for a reptile. Of course, you could do it really, really nice and really, really beautiful and spend a lot more on it, but the basic setup that the snake is going to need to thrive is not particularly expensive. And even the snake can be obtained at a very reasonable price. And the only reason that we dock them a point on upfront cost is just if you want one that doesn't look like a wild-type Hognose Snake, you might pay through the teeth for it. Hundreds, even thousands of dollars for the animal. Now, you can buy a wild-type Hognose Snake for $50, and they're beautiful. I think they're just one of the most spectacular-looking snakes out there. Frankly, they look a little bit like rattlesnakes, and rattlesnakes are one of the coolest snakes on the planet. So once again, overall, we give the Western Hognose Snake a score of 4.2 out of 5 because they're amazing. This is one of the best pet snakes you can possibly get. We love them. You will love them. As always, like and subscribe, and we hope to see you real soon.
Got it, Lou.
Know your way around a clacker.
Yeah.
Awkward.
Look at that schnoz. This snake's name is Darkside. She's super dark for a wild type Hognose snake, and she's got like a perfect Jedi symbol on her head, but she's honestly way too dark to be a Jedi.